Hey there, and welcome back. So in the previous video, I gave you this demo of this AI-powered interior decorating app. It includes everything from user authentication to payment processing, web analytics, and this also includes integration with other AI services. But how do we get started with this? Of course, you might want to use something like Lovable or Bolt, but to be honest, I've never seen anyone build a real-world production application using any of those platforms. So instead, we'll start this project locally on our own machine, and we'll use Claude Code to build this application for us. Now, just a side note, you don't have to use Claude Code. Any coding agent will work. So let's briefly discuss the tech stack. We will be using Next.js. This is a really popular framework for building real-world SaaS applications, and it's used by some of the world's largest companies. In fact, a lot of these app builders that you're familiar with actually use Next.js under the hood. And the reason we're using Next.js is it actually deals with everything on the front end as well as the back end. Then for the design system, we will be using ShadCN. This gives us a list of beautiful components that we can use in our application. For user authentication, we will be using a library called BetterAuth. As with a lot of the tools and libraries in this series, BetterAuth is open source. For the database, we will be using Postgres. I've tried a lot of different types of databases in my life, and Postgres just stands out, especially if you're building applications that could potentially require vector embeddings or full text search. Postgres is easy to work with, and it does everything. Now, we will look at payment processing and web analytics further down in this video, but for now, this is our core tech stack and everything you really need to know. And for the AI functionality, we will be using the AI SDK from Vercel. I've tried a lot of different AI libraries, and the AI SDK is really phenomenal. And we'll then combine the AI SDK with OpenRouter to get access to hundreds of different models. Now, I do want to mention, you don't have to use OpenRouter. The AI SDK is also capable of integrating directly with the providers. To get started, open up your code editor. I'll be using VS Code, but of course you can use Cursor or whatever you want. I've opened up a new folder called Plushify. This is going to be similar to our AI-powered interior decorating app in that users will upload images of themselves or their family or their pets, and we'll then use an AI model to convert the subjects in those images to plushies. This will also work off a credit system, so users will start off with a few free credits, and they can then purchase additional credits to continue using the application. So how do we now set up our project? So if we wanted to, we could install each of these frameworks individually. So we could start with Next.js, and then maybe install ShadCN, then BetterAuth, and then set up a Postgres database. But instead, I'm going to show you an even easier way. I've created this boilerplate project that you can use for free. This greatly speeds up the process of setting up that initial project. So if you want, you can go through this article to see how it works, but I'll simply show you. So what we have to do is in our code editor, open up your terminal and run the command npx create agentic app at latest and period. This will set up the boilerplate project in its current working directory. So we'll just say yes to install this. Then you can select your package manager. I'll just use pnpm, and that will copy across all of these files. It will also install all of the dependencies and initiate a Git repository. In fact, if we go to version control, we can already see this initial commit. So that's really it. This might seem intimidating, but it's actually really straightforward. In the Claude folder, this template already gives you access to a few sub-agents. So we've got this BetterAuth expert, a Polar expert, and a UI developer. We also have a few commands. So we can use checkpoints to easily create commits, and we can use create feature to plan and create a new feature. It's kind of similar to what SpecKit does. Then we also have this docs folder where I've stored some technical information on using our AI framework, as well as BetterAuth. But of course, we'll build all of this out together during the course of this series. Now for the main project files, we can open up the source directory, and within app, we can view all of the files that make up this project. Now you don't really have to worry too much about these files. This is not a crash course in Next.js. We will be using our agent to do the bulk of the work. So this is really just a high level FYI. Within app, you'll have this page file. This is really the main page of our web app. Then if you have any nested routes, like /dashboard, then this is where we'll find the dashboard page or the user's profile page, etc. Then we can also store any reusable components in the components folder. Like if we open up UI, we can see things like buttons and cards and dialogues and badges, etc. And of course, we can use ShadCN to install additional components into this project. Then we can also start our development server to view our app by opening up the terminal, and we can then run npm run dev, or if you want to, you can use pnpm run dev. This will start our project on localhost 3000, and from here we can see our boilerplate project. Of course, we'll replace all of this with our actual app. All right, so when we click on sign in, nothing happens. And that is because we still have to set up our database and authentication. So basically everything in this checklist. Thankfully, this is really simple. In this project, I've already created a Docker Compose file that will automatically start up a Postgres database for you. And in order to run a Postgres database locally, we will be using Docker Desktop. So simply go to docker.com and download and install Docker Desktop. Then in Docker Desktop, you won't see any containers running yet. So back in our project, we can actually just start a new terminal session and run the command docker compose up-d. The first time you run this command, it will download the Postgres image and then start your container. So in Docker Desktop, I can now see my Plushify folder and we have our Postgres database. Now you might be wondering if you need to change anything in the .env file, and the answer is no. For development, I've set up like a default user, a default password, and the database can be accessed from localhost 5432, and this is the database name, Postgres dev. These values can also be found in this Docker Compose file. So if you don't change anything here, then you don't have to change anything in the .env file. All right, so our database is currently up and running. And if we click on recheck, this step is still red. That is because we haven't migrated the tables across to our database. It simply means our database is currently empty. And if you ever wanted to see the contents of your database, what you can do is run the command npm run db studio. This will give you this drizzle URL. And here we can view all the tables in our database. And as you can see, we don't have any tables. And this step is basically telling us that we need to migrate across all the user authentication tables to our database. And we can do that by running this simple command. So I'll just copy this and I'll just open up a new terminal session, it's paste in that command and run migrate. Now, if we go back to our database, we can see a few more tables. Now, you don't have to worry about the specifics around these four tables. Just know that these are used by BetterAuth to implement a user authentication system. And also we can view all the tables in code by going to source, lib, and the schema file. So in the schema file, we can see the definition for the user table, sessions, account, and verification. So let's say we wanted to add a new table to this database. We can obviously type it out ourselves, or if we open up a new session and start up Claude Code, we could just say, hey, please add one more table to our database called to-do. This table will store to-do items for our users. All right, so let's run this. And Claude Code just added this to-do table to the database. Now, by default, you won't see those new tables because we have to migrate them to the database. Again, to do that, what we have to do is run npm run db generate. And this will generate a DB migration. And finally, we have to run the command. And let's just clear this. And after we've created the generation, we can run DB migrate, just like we did before. Now, if we go back to the table, we can see that to-do table along with the columns that we created in the schema file. Now, this was just for interest's sake. I actually don't want this table, so I'm just going to delete it. And like you just learned, in order to apply the changes to the database, we'll run db generate followed by db migrate. And now the table should be gone, which it is. So I wanted to show you these db commands for a reason. Throughout the series, the agent will be making changes to our database. And if we don't generate and migrate those changes, our application will fail. It will fail because it will try to interact with tables that don't yet exist in the database. Right, so now that we've run the migrations, the database connection and schema is complete. Now let's set up auth. Our application uses BetterAuth, which is a fantastic open source auth library. And BetterAuth supports a lot of different providers. So obviously we've got email and password verification, but we also support social providers like Apple and Discord and Facebook, Google, GitHub, and much, much more. We'll be using Google as our provider. And in order to use Google, we need to set up our Google client ID and a Google client secret, and then add those to our .env file, to these fields over here. So what we need to do is go to Google Cloud Platform, then click on Console. So from here, we need to create a new project. So let's click on this dropdown. Let's click on New Project. I'll just call this Splashify AI. Let's create this. And it will just take a few seconds to create this project. And there we go. Let's click on Select Project. Then on the left-hand side, let's go to APIs and Services. And let's click on OAuth Consent Screen. This is that little pop-up that shows up when selecting your Google accounts. Let's click on Get Started. For the app name, let's call this Splashify AI. And let's select our email. On the next, let's select External and Next. Let's enter our email address. Then let's agree to the terms, continue, and create. Then click on Audience, click on Publish App, confirm. Then finally go to Clients, create client. Then under application type, let's select web app. And for the name, let's just say Splashify AI. And then very important, under authorized redirect URIs, let's click on add URI. And for the value, I left a note in the .env file. So you can simply copy this URI and paste it into this field. Cool. Once we deploy this app to production and we have our production domain, we will come back to this page and add the production domain as well. Let's click on create, and this will give us our client ID and client secret. So let's copy the ID, add it to our .env file. Let's copy the secret and add that as well. So when we click on recheck, our environment variables are now set up. We've got our database and our auth is indeed configured. Now, if you are planning to add AI capabilities to your application, like what we'll be doing, you have to configure your AI integration as well. And like I mentioned, we are using OpenRouter. So it simply means that in this file, we have to provide our OpenRouter API key. So go to openrouter.ai and sign up for your account. Then click on Keys and click on Create API Key. Give it a name and click on Create. Then copy this key and add it to your .env file over here. Now keep in mind, depending on which model you use, you will be charged for that model. So I do recommend adding a few credits to your account. Either way, when we click on recheck, everything is now green. So we should be able to now test authentication and our AI integration. Let's click on sign in and look at that. We can now select our Google account. So let's select this one. Let's click on continue. And we're now signed into our dashboard. And by the way, if we were not signed in, we would not be able to access the dashboard. We'll just get this message saying that this is a protected page. So I'll just sign in again. And we can also test the AI capabilities by going to go to chat. And let's say, hey, what model are you? Let's send this. And the response just streamed in. Cool. So our AI integration is indeed working. And by the way, since we're using OpenRouter, we can easily swap out our models. So let's say we didn't want to use OpenAI, we wanted to use Claude 4 Sonnet instead. We can simply copy the string and back in our ENV file, simply replace the OpenRouter model with the string that we just copied. Then back in our app, if we ask, what model are you? We should now get a response from Anthropic, which we do. Now that we've got our project set up, we can finally start building our SaaS application. Please let me know down in the comments if you've got any questions related to this series, and I'll try my best to address all of those in the next few videos. Also, hit the subscribe button to be notified as soon as I publish the next videos, and it will also greatly support my channel. I'll see you in the next one.